In the last video, I introduced you to the Bell numbers, and we have proven that B of n plus 1 is given by the recurrence relation sum from I equals to 0 to n of n choose I times B of I. And using this recurrence relation, today we are going to prove that the exponential generating function of the Bell numbers is this gorgeous formula e to the e to the x minus 1. And what do I mean by the exponential generating function? Well, I'm saying that this e to the e to the x minus 1 has the Taylor series expansion about 0 of b of 0 plus b of 1 times x over 1 factorial plus b of 2 times x squared over 2 factorial plus b of 3 times x cubed over 3 factorial, and so on. So in other words, that this e to the e to the x minus 1 is in some sense a compact representation of the Bell numbers. And you can use your favorite mathematical software to find this Maclaurin expansion, and using that you can find the values of the Bell numbers. You know what, let's actually try it using Wolfram Alpha. So we want to find the Taylor series expansion of e to the x minus 1 about x equals to 0. And let's go all the way to the x to the fifth term. Once we calculate this, we get this Taylor series expansion. For now, let's focus on the coefficient of x cubed, which is 5 over 6. So we have seen that the Maclaurin expansion of e to the e to the x minus 1 has coefficient of x cubed of 5 over 6, and because 3 cubed is 6, that's telling us b of 3 is 5. And in the last video, we have verified that b of 3 is 5, so it looks like this formula is actually working. So how do we prove this? Well, we're going to use this recurrence relation we derived in the last video. So we want to show b of x, which we will define as the summation from n equals to 0 to infinity of b of n times x to the n over n factorial is equal to e to the e to the x minus 1. And from the recurrence relation, we are going to multiply. This is a common thing to do when you're working with a generating function. We are going to multiply by x to the nth power and divide by n factorial. So same thing on the right side. We have a summation from I equals to 0 to n, and choose I, b of I. And to this entire thing, we are going to multiply by x to the nth over n factorial, and we are going to sum it up from n equals to 0 to infinity. And as we are about to find out, both of these expressions have an intimate connection to this exponential generating function b of x. For example, the left-hand side is b prime of x. Why is this? Well, b of x is, from how we defined it, b of 0 plus b of 1 x over 1 factorial plus b of 2 x squared over 2 factorial. Let's go one more. Plus b of 3 x cubed over 3 factorial, and so on. So what is going to happen when we differentiate this? So b prime of x is going to be, b of 0 is going to go away, b of 1x over 1 factorial is going to become b of 1, b of 2x squared over 2 factorial is going to become b of 2x over 1 factorial, this 2 is going to go out, 2 over 2 factorial is 1 factorial, plus b of 3x squared over 2 factorial, because this 3 is going to drop down, and so on. And we see that's exactly what we have on the left-hand side. As n goes from 0 to infinity, we have a b of 1 plus b of 2x to the first over 1 factorial, b of 3x squared over 2 factorial, and so on. So the left-hand side is in fact b prime of x. Now, how do we simplify the right-hand side? It actually turns out, very surprisingly, the right-hand side is going to be b of x times a summation from n equals to 0 to infinity of x to the nth over n factorial. You may recognize this summation from n equals to 0 to infinity of x to the nth over n factorial as e to the x. So the right hand side is b of x times e to the x. How do we show this? Well, let's think about what b of x times this Taylor series expansion for e to the x is going to get us. We know from our definition, b of x is the summation from n equals to 0 to infinity, let me write this down, of b of n times x to the n over n factorial. And to this, we are multiplying this summation from n equals to 0 to infinity of x to the n over n factorial. Let's think about what the coefficient of x to the k is going to be once we multiply this out. Well, to get x to the k, we can multiply x to the 0 term on this first expression to x to the k term in the second expression. Or we can multiply x to the first term in the first expression to x to the k minus 1 term in the second expression, because once we multiply them, we are going to get x to the k. Or we can multiply x squared term in the first one to x to the k minus 2 in the second one, and so on, until we multiply the x to the k term in the first expression by x to the 0 term in the final expression. So that's telling us that the coefficient of x to the k should be summation from I equals to 0 all the way to k, and we are going to be multiplying coefficient of x to the I in the first expression by coefficient of x to the k minus I in the second expression. So that's first and that's second. So when we multiply these two, for example, x to the first and x to the k minus 1, that's when I is 1. So when we multiply these two, we are going to get coefficient of x to the k. And what is this going to be? That's summation from I equals to 0 to k, coefficient of x to the I in the first expression is b of I over I factorial, coefficient of x to the k minus I in the second expression is 1 over k minus I factorial. Now remember that we wanted to prove that this expression is equal to this expression. And another way of saying it is that we want to prove that the coefficient of x to the k in this expression is equal to coefficient of x to the k in the original expression for every value of k. And we see that for this expression, coefficient of x to the k is going to be, that's when n is equal to k, summation from I equals to 0 to k of k choose I times b of I. And we cannot forget dividing by n factorial, or in this case k factorial, because in our case n is k when we have x to the k power. So let's go back down. So we want to show that 1 over k factorial times the summation from I equals to 0 to k of k choose I times b of I is equal to this thing. But that's very easy to do, because k choose I is k factorial over I factorial times k minus I factorial. And once the k factorial is cancelled out, we have precisely what we want. So we have shown that the right-hand side is b of x times e to the x. Now let's finish it up. So we know b prime of x is equal to b of x times e to the x. Another way of writing this, letting b of x be y, is dy dx is equal to y times e to the x. And we can solve this differential equation using separation, 1 over y dy is e to the x dx, and solving this gets us natural log of y is e to the x plus c, or y is e to the x plus c. So we know from this that b of x is equal to e to the x plus c. We are very close to being done. And we know by convention that b of 0 is equal to 1. So when we plug x equals to 0 into this formula, we want to get the output of 1. That's telling us that e to the 0 is 1, 1 plus c has to be 1. That's telling us that 1 plus c is 0, or c is negative 1. So we know b of x is e to the x minus 1. So let's go back up. So we have shown that the exponential generating function for b of x is e to the x minus 1.